troubles you face. All of us have problems, troubles, things in our life that come up against us. But did you know the key of dealing with problems is how you deal with them, understanding where they're coming from? A matter of fact, if we can learn how to deal with our troubles, our problems, it's possible that we're going to survive longer in our life, meaning we're going to have a better life, we're going to know how to navigate through the different things. But every one of us in this room have troubles. Last week, we talked about dealing with disappointments. It was in the top of the chapter 13, in the first 6-7 verses. We moving on down into chapter 13 here of the book of Matthew, and it's talking about the parable of the weeds. Last week it was the parable of the sower. This week, the parable of the weeds. Jesus is teaching it. He's talking to his disciples. He's in the boat on the Sea of Galilee, and there was a large crowd that come, and he gets in the boat, and he begins to talk to his disciples or the crowds about different things in life. We talked about that a lot of times in the 1st of January, people look at their lives and they wish it was a little better. They wish that things weren't, they didn't have all the troubles or the problems in their life, and it would be easy to get discouraged. We're looking at this parable, the parable of the weeds, and to see how it applies to our life. Really, when it's talking about the parable of the weeds, it's talking about how the farmer sowed good seeds in a part of his ground, and it was a good harvest, but there were weeds that came up. But let's read the scripture verse here. It says, Jesus told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. The parable prior to this was the one we talked about last week, but he goes, but while everyone was sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. When the wheat sprouted and formed heads, then the weeds also appeared. The owner's servants came to him and said, sir, didn't you sow good seed in your field? Where then did these weeds come from? Verse 28 says, an enemy did this, he replied. The servants asked him, do you want us to go and pull them up? No, he answered, because while you're pulling up the weeds, you may root up the wheat with them. Let them both grow together until the harvest. Once again, we're talking about the different troubles and hardships that you and I have. This is a parable about a farmer who went out to sow, and at the end of last week, we said that there was other seed that fell on good soil. That's kind of where we're picking up. We're picking up on the part, the good things that are going on in our life. You see, sometimes when we have problems, we look at the problems in our life and we say, these are the predominant things that are going on. And it's easy to discount the good things. Well, I kind of really want to go through the verses quickly here because I kind of think they speak for themselves. Jesus told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. When I looked at that, first of all, the kingdom of heaven, I was thinking about Jesus and kind of went through the parable. He says the kingdom of heaven. So immediately I thought that he must be talking to the people of God, believers. Well, the people of God having problems. He says the kingdom of God is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. So he immediately identifies it as something to do with heaven. May I say initially that sometimes as believers, we don't think we should have trouble. We think everything ought to go right. But Jesus made it clear in starting off this parable, he says the kingdom of heaven is like this. So what Jesus is giving us a clue is that as followers of Christ, we're going to have difficulties in our life. Sometimes by just knowing that and knowing that God knows that we're going to have problems, it helps us. We know that some days we're going to have things that come against us. We're going to have a phone call that we don't like. We're going to have something that comes in the mail. You are going to have things that come against you that you don't like. whatever it may be in your profession or your job, there's things. He says, the kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. Once again, who sowed good seed. Sometimes when we're talking about the troubles we have, or we're talking about the problems in our life, we forget that there's good things going on in our life also. It says here, he sowed good seed in his field. When we're looking at field, and we're just setting this up because there's some good thoughts down below, but his field, our life. It's a parable about our life. He said, the farmer sowed good seed in his field. Listen, there's good things going on in your life, even though sometimes it's hard to understand what God is doing in our life. Many times we look at our life and we see the problem. We see that our kids aren't doing, we see that our job, our boss, we're having trouble with things, our finances. And it's so easy to look at all the different things in our life and discount or forget the good things that are happening. Well, let's continue on in verse 25. But while everyone was sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. While any was sleeping, sometimes things come our way that are no fault of our own. It says here that while everyone is sleeping, the enemy came. Everyone has to sleep. Everyone has to, the farmer here that had to get rest. You're wondering many times where your troubles come from, relationships, breakups of friendships, whatever it may be. It says here that while the enemy was sleeping, sometimes when things come our way, we're wondering, how did this happen? And we look at our troubles and we start to question. It says here, while they were sleeping, the enemy came and sowed seeds. May I say this, my friend? The enemy is out to destroy what God wants to do in your life. The enemy wants to hurt you. The enemy wants to cause problems in your family with relationships. If you're starting a relationship or a job or whatever, the enemy knows that God is working in your life, and he immediately tries to sow things that would disqualify what God is doing. See, Satan is at competition with God. You're here because you want God in your life. You're here because you want God to help you. You're here because you know that if you have more of God, that you could get through your challenges, your struggles, your hardships. But the enemy is competing for your space. The enemy is competing for your mind. The enemy is competing for your life. The enemy wants to take over your life. The enemy wants to sow so much discord, problems in your life, so that it's you become full of the enemy and not full of God. But that's why God created the Sabbath. So that we can then clear our mind, that we could get more of God in our life, and we could be stronger and combat those things that come against us. You see, it's not that you're not going to have trouble. You are going to have trouble. But the difference is, and we're going to continue on here, the difference is having God in your life has a way of helping you through those difficulties. But while everyone was sleeping, his enemy came. I just want to tell you, the enemy is going to come against you. You're here saying, wow, if I go to church, I'm going to have a great week. It's possible by you going to church, the enemy knows that God is doing good things in your life. If you try to get over that addiction, the enemy is going to fight you that much harder. You know, when I became a believer, 17, I went back and forth for years, you know, after that. But you know what? I thought, wow. I'm giving up this, I'm giving up marijuana, I'm giving up this, I'm giving up that. I won't get into the other things I had to give up, but giving up, everything ought to go smooth right now. But did you know, that's when I started having one attack after another in other areas, family, this, all sorts of different things. Why? Because the enemy knows that he was losing his grip. Here it says, that there was good seed that was sown in the field in your life. You're sowing good seed right now in your field, in your life, by being obedient to God this morning, by following his desire for you. Listen, but while everyone was sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds. What are weeds? It's the opposite of the good seed. In competition, You need to know, once again, before we go on, that the enemy is in competition for your family. See, the enemy wants to create havoc in your life so that you don't win. You see, if you win, he loses. This is a competition. This is something that is big, because if your harvest comes up, God begins to bless you. God, things work out and God's will is in your life. Well, the enemy don't want that to happen. If you start praying, you start thanking the Lord, you're living your life in obedience, you're going to find your dreams, the desires that God has for you. The enemy don't want you to find your purpose. The enemy don't want you to find your calling. Just think if you found your calling. Just think if you found your purpose. Just think if you found the right mate. Just think if you found God's best for you. Your life would be changed. Things would be fruitful in your life. Not saying you're not going to have problems, but the enemy wants to stop you. The enemy wants to hold you back and tie you down, because you're a dangerous person to him as you begin to live for God. Listen, when it says here that the weeds among the wheat, let's continue. I'm sorry. Verse 26, when the wheat sprouted and formed heads. Sometimes we think that nothing is going to happen or nothing is going to work out. We think, I went to church, I prayed, I gave, I brought some food. Hey, for you visitors, feel free to stay for the lunch right afterwards. It's right after, and we fellowship around. That is a little info commercial. Feel free to stay, maybe for a few minutes, get to know someone, and you're welcome to stay. You don't have to, of course, bring anything, but feel free to stay. But it says, when the wheat sprouted. Sometimes we think that, it's not going to happen. It's not going to work out. But listen, if you're part of the kingdom of God, if you're part of what God wants to do, the kingdom of heaven, and you are, or you wouldn't be here today, if that's you, it's going to sprout out. The things are going to come forth. You're thinking, well, nothing is going to work out. Some of you say, why don't you take a drink of that? I'm going to. Wow, I don't know if anything's going to work out. It says, when the wheat sprouted and formed heads. So here's what happens. There's good seed. There's good things going on in your life. There's good seed in your ground, in your field, in your life. I know many times you can't see it. You wonder if it's ever going to come up, if your ship is ever going to come in, if it's ever going to work out. But stay with God. It does work out. Listen, here it says, when the wheat sprouted, it is going to happen. If you pray and stand in agreement with God, with his word, it's going to happen. Listen, it says when, it's not if, it's when. So that's why it's so important, as all the people of faith of the scriptures in Hebrews chapter 11, they had to wait on God. They had to trust him. And many times God wants to see if you're really serious about wanting his purposes in your life. So he allows testings. He allows things to happen. But when the wheat sprouted and formed head, it is going to sprout in your life. That thing is going to form. Those relationships, that thing you desire, it is going to form. You know, if I had any advice for a young person, now that I'm older and you know what it would be? It would be to be strong. Don't worry about those things that are trying to get you off track. Keep going forward, because you will get there. But when we're going through the challenge of life, it's so easy to go to the left, to abandon ship, to think nothing's working out. But listen, it says, when the wheat sprouted and formed heads, then the weeds also appeared. Some of you are thinking, wow, it's something good happened. Did you know if something good happens, it's probably going to be followed by something bad, some kind of bad news? I know, that's not something we want to hear this morning, but it's true. We're talking about dealing with trouble, problems in our life. If we can learn to understand trouble, it's possible that we can navigate our lives in a more successful way. It's possible that we can get through things. I remember when I was in charge of the Teen Challenge Center in Hawaii. We had a problem with the state, and they were switching over to the faith-based stuff, incoming administrations in D.C., and you know, it was all new on the horizon, and people are debating it. But I remember this one person started coming after us in government a little bit because possibly some faith-based dollars were coming our way, and they didn't want to lose it up into the health things, and it was new for us, and I was younger, I didn't understand it all. But at this one person, I had some different interns, they were younger, and staff members, and I should have known better, but he got saved, and he was a good guy. Could be watching right now, he's in California, good guy, but he says, let's jack him, John. Let's jack him. And you know, I'm a competitive person a little bit, and you know, if you don't want jack, it means just go after him, you know. So here's what we did. We had like 7 or 8 staff members there in the office, and we wrote letters to our congressmen, the senators, and all these things, and you know, something that we probably should have let go and let simmer a while, we made it worse because we overreacted. Now, maybe that you'll understand that point in a little bit as we get down to the bottom, but it's so important that you don't overreact when trouble comes in your life. When you see the different things, well, let's continue on. The weeds also appeared. Whenever good things happen, then trouble. Did you know at that point in our program, it seems like we were running on all 8 cylinders? We had favor, the governor, all the different things. We were really on the scene that a lot of people worked for. But then all of a sudden, we had trouble. Don't worry about those things that come in your life that you're wondering, wow, I went to church and I got this phone call now. Maybe that's you're on the right track, and maybe that trouble is being sparked because God is doing something in your life. Well, let's continue on. The owner's servants came to him and said, sir, didn't you sow good seed in your field? This is where I like the next 3 verses. The others were preparatory a little bit. The owners came to him, sir, didn't you sow good seed in your field? Where then did the weeds come from? If you've ever lived life at all and you've been through a hardship in your life, it's easy to question things when you're going through a struggle. Here, the servants were saying, didn't you do this? Didn't you pray? Didn't you do this? Why? It's easy to have questions when you're going through hard times. And those questions can easily derail you, get you off, get you double-minded, get you thinking that nothing good is happening. We see here that they saw problems. Weeds were problems. Weeds were trouble. Weeds were something that could choke out the good plants. Here, the wheat was coming up. This is a parable. Jesus was teaching it. And now some weeds, some problems were starting to be formed. We know that good things were happening. And then it says, well, didn't you? Why did this happen? It would be easy for family members to say to you, aren't you going to church? Aren't you trying to live life? Why is this happening? It would be easy for you to question yourself in your mind. What's going on? I thought that God had a plan for me. Why now does it seem like everything is falling apart? You, many times, there's times where you go through questioning that would be easy for you to kind of second guess what God is doing in your life. You got to be strong. We're talking about troubles. Try to understand the problems in our life. Understanding the things we go through. Listen, once again, if you can navigate through your trouble, at the end of the day, you're going to come out successful. I don't want to give this illustration. I probably shouldn't. Don't throw anything at me. You know, I said I was never going to give another campaign illustration, but this is a neutral. I remember when the president-elect was, that's how I'll say it, going through, and it seemed like it was 2 weeks where something came out that it was horrific, and it was on the media over and over. I said, wow, listen to this. I said, this is terrible. He needs to quit. He needs to quit. I heard it. As a matter of fact, I had to cover my ears sometimes hearing the tape over. I got to stop now. Hearing the tape, I'm thinking, this is terrible. And I didn't want my kids to hear it. And I'm thinking, wow, this guy needs to quit. And one of my kids were 4, and one of my other kids were 4 or the other. And, you know, I had split like a lot of our families do. And, you know, I said, this is too much. Stay with me. This is just an illustration. But did you know what? I remember him getting up, the president-elect getting up and say, I'm not going to quit. And you know what? I'm thinking, you're stupid. You ought to just, that's terrible. But did you know what? Now, this is just an illustration. He ended up winning. Now, here's what I'm getting at. This is just something, I started thinking about that later. You know why he never quit? Probably because he's built some buildings before. He had every inspector come against him and all the different trials. He probably had bad cement. He had to rip up. He had so many things, but he'd been through so many different adversarial times. He knew that this could pass. Now, this is just an illustration for us this morning. And then the only reason I'm using it, sometimes we look at our life and we think nothing good can come out of this. But many times, if we just keep going forward, that God has a way of bringing us through and helping us get beyond it. We look at all the trouble. We look at all the different things and we say, no, it's too much. As a matter of fact, I know I would have quit. But and I'm not taking sides on either or, but what I'm saying is, but it was probably wise that on his, that he's been through so many things. Some of you have been through hell in your life, or not just hell, you've been through struggles. And the enemy is trying to bring you down now. You got to look back on the things you've been through and said, devil, you can't mess me up this. I know your tactics. I know I'm going to keep going forward. I'm going to keep serving God. And then I know that he will bring me through. That's the illustration. Here we go. The owner's servant said, okay, let's go to 28. An enemy did this. He says, didn't you questions? Be careful about the questions in hard times. What? I remember the first church planted, came out in Naperville. We built a building, and after our first service, we did it ourselves. I remember my hands were bloody a little bit. I came in the first service, and we built it for just a handful of us. But I remember an older lady came up to me and says, Pastor, this is our first service in the building. Pastor, we were, and as I'm walking up the aisle, we were bigger before we built the building. You know what that did for me? My heart sank. She was right, because I looked out and I saw the crowd. I said, oh, I'm discouraged. I got to go back to Naperville where there's 3,000, where I was assistant pastor. And I was discouraged and I felt humiliated. She was right. She was just giving an observation of our first Sunday. And our attendance that first Sunday was low and I was discouraged. But did you know, as I look today, being a little older and weathering things, you know, you don't judge things on one Sunday. Same with you in your life. You don't judge things on what you're going through a certain season in your life. You might be going through a season of difficult hardships. It doesn't mean that good things are not around the corner. It doesn't mean that God has given up on you. It doesn't mean that there's not good seeds in the field, in your soil. You just got to hang on and keep going forward and allow God to do his work. Okay, verse 28. An enemy did this, he replied. So here now, the little more seasoned farmer. You got to be seasoned. You got to know how to navigate your troubles. He identified it for what it is. Friend, identify your problems for where they are. Meaning, some of you are blaming this person. You're blaming culture. You're blaming our elected officials. You're blaming the company for the reason you're restless. You're blaming your kids. You're blaming that. Listen. Here's what the seasoned farmer, the seasoned person, and this is a parable that Jesus is teaching the people. He says, where did this come from? An unseasoned person would allow panic to ensue. But if you're ahead of that household, if you're ahead of your children, you got to bring the temperature down. You got to say, we could get through this. We got to hold on. Let's go to church. Let's believe God. We could get through this trouble. This ain't going to get the best. This ain't going to define our family. Here it says, an enemy did this. Here the person identified it for what it is. Here's what I'd like to say to us. You know, someone says, oh, the devil made me do it. You know, listen, I'm starting to say, yeah, you're right. What I mean is you know, it's easy to blame the enemy. But I'm into blaming the enemy for anything bad in my life. What I'm saying is, it says right there, the enemy did this, he replied. Jesus was saying through his parable that it's the attack of the enemy that is creating havoc in your life. It ain't your mother-in-law. It ain't your father-in-law. It ain't this. It ain't that. It ain't. But listen, the enemy is trying to bring you down through your addiction. The enemy is trying to bring you down through that quarrel. The enemy is trying to use all his mechanisms in life to hurt you. But you got to identify. If you can identify where you're at, it's easy to fight it a little more. We know that's what MacArthur said, right? In the Philippines, he identified it. But listen here, an enemy did this. Who is the one that is sowing bad seeds in your life that's trying to hurt you? The enemy. You started out life with believing that good things, but the enemy sowed in discontent. The enemy sowed in things, and you've been through some struggles, and you're here today, and you're with some pieces, and you don't know how you're going to make it. You got to start off by saying, the enemy tried to ruin me, but I'm not going to have it. I'm going to keep going forward with God. The enemy tried to ruin my marriage. Listen, the enemy wants to ruin every marriage in this house. The enemy don't want Christian marriages to survive. Listen, because if a Christian marriage survives, that means a Christian community survives. That means followers of God survive. That means communities get stronger. That means the nation gets stronger. The enemy wants to bring you down where you're at. An enemy did this, he replied. Call it for what it is. We believe it's this. We're so into calling things that are not really the where they're at. Oh, it's this person, it's that person. But really, the enemy is trying to destroy what God is doing in your life. Do you want to go and pull it up? Now listen, even though you understand you have trouble, you got to be cautious. And I gave the illustration earlier to you about me in Hawaii. You got to be cautious. You have trouble in your life, but you got to learn to navigate it through the proper way. Here, the wisdom of the farmer. He says, do you want me now to go and pull it up? These are the same servants that said, where did this come from? Creating questions. They haven't been through this before. They're unseasoned. You've been through things. That's why you're a parent. That's why you're a grandparent. That's why you're a leader. That's why you've been through a hardship in your marriage, a divorce. You now can navigate and help others. An enemy did this. Should we go and pull it up? Shall we get out of it? Should we quit? Should we fold in the tent? There's trouble. Let's quit. Let's give it up. There's nothing good in this job. There's nothing good in this relationship. Let's give it up. It would be so easy to allow what the enemy is bringing in your life to be the one that is directing you. Don't allow your troubles to direct you. Allow God to direct you. I'm not saying there's not a new job for you. I'm not saying there's not a new opportunity for you. I didn't say that. But don't allow your troubles to dictate which way you're going, because you're going to have troubles the next juncture you get at. We see here, do you want me to pull them up? Should I go and deal with these things? I like the wisdom of the person that's been through struggles and hardships. No, he answered. Sometimes you just got to weather through your hardships. I remember my family. We grew up in the bakery trade. Every January and February, there's seven of us. We were little, growing up, going to work every morning. I remember January and February, I'd hear my dad and my mom talking, acting like we're going broke. I thought I'd have to go out and get another job at 6 years old. You know, we're going broke. The business is cut in half. Well, everybody's trying to go on a diet. And if you're a bakery in January, it's common sense that it's going to go down. You had a good holiday or whatever, and now people are saying, as they're getting fat, oh, I'm going to quit eating donuts. So it would go down, but they would always bewail it like they were going under. We had several bakeries throughout Illinois and Iowa, it's terrible. My brothers are in it now, and I hear them saying the same thing. And I'm saying, I don't want to hear it. Because you know why? February 14th, around Valentine's comes in, you get those cookie orders, Valentine's, those smiley cookies, and things begin to change. And then Easter comes around, and it begins to be a progression. Here's what I want to say for you. You're going to get through what you're going through. You're going to get through this struggle, my brother, my sister. Hang on. Stay in there. Keep praying. Keep believing. You're going to get through this. You're going to get through this struggle that you're going through. You're going to get through these things. I know you're here. You're bemoaning. No, it's not going to work. It's not going to, I don't know how. No. And you're about ready to go this way and that way. Listen, I pastored a little bit now. You know what the biggest thing where I see people dropping out of church is? They get discouraged because it didn't happen quick enough. This, we would be filled to capacity right now if everybody would be here. But you know what? And I'm not blaming that because I'd be one of those. I gotta be. I'm the pastor and I live here up front, so I have no excuse. But you know, there's so many things that discourage us, bring us down. We don't think it's gonna work. Can you say, devil, you've given your best shot. I've been through this last year. I've been through it January, February last year. I've been through this. You're not gonna win here. And can you keep going on with God and keep going forward? Listen here, an enemy did this, he replied. The servants asked him, do you want us to go and pull it up? No, he answered. Listen, because while you're pulling the weeds, you may root up the wheat also with them. You see, that tells me that there is good things going on in your life. God is doing good things. The wheat is coming up in your January, in your winter. The wheat is still working. It's still making its way. If you can hang in there, you're going to see what God has been doing in your life the whole time. The dreams, the prayers that you prayed are going to be answered. But you know it says in Daniel that he prayed a prayer? Here's what Daniel prayed a prayer and it should have been answered. Do you know what it said in Daniel? He says, why did it take so long, Daniel answered later, for you to come and answer it? He said, because there was a fight in the heavenlies in order for the prayers to break through. That's kind of a description of what's going on in your life. There's a fight going on and you got to win this fight. You got to be strong where you're at today. After I said about January 20th, it's the highest suicide rate. Forget that. Listen, God can get you through your blues or your hard times. He can get you through that addiction. No, he answered, because while you're pulling up the weeds, you may root up the weed also. There's the good things that God is doing. And don't discount everything that's going on in your life because you got some trouble over here. And you're pulling it up and you've ruined the rest of your life that God wanted to bring you through. God knows what he's doing in your life. Be strong, my friends. Troubles, they're there. Troubles, they're part of our life, but God wants to help us through them. God gave us a parable to help us through the troubles that you and I face. He tried to help us with life because there are life matters. You can get through this thing. As a matter of fact, at the end of the day, you know what it says? That the harvest was so big, it was so bountiful, that the good things that were going on outweighed the weeds. Listen, sometimes troubles, you have a good day on Tuesday, a good on Wednesday, and they're simultaneous throughout the week. But at the end of the day, you're here. You're still going forward. God still is working in your life. And matter of fact, I will say this, and I am done. If you stay faithful to God, I promise you this. If you keep doing your best, I'm not saying everything's going to be perfect. I know 1 year from now, no, 6 months from now, I know, matter of fact, by Easter, you're going to see some things break forth that are going to come forth in your life that you never thought could happen. Keep going forward for God. Keep allowing. But if you give up now, if you say it's not worth it, the weeds, the troubles, it's too big, too much for me to handle. That's all I'm seeing is the weeds. I understand that. Get your eye off the weeds. Get your eye off what God is doing in your life. The good things at the end of the day, they're there. Father, bless your people, I pray. Help them. Work in their life. There's someone here, and I'm sorry for going a little long, but if there's someone